Good morning students, in this class I will be doing class 9 Savachir Kalvi syllabus or matriculation syllabus 5th chapter coordinate geometry exercise 5.4 7th sub. A line segment AB is increased along its length by 25% by producing it to C on the side of B. If A and B have the coordinates, so for A and B the coordinates are given respectively, then find the coordinates of C. So this is the information given. So a line segment is given AB. So the coordinates of A and B is given. Okay, then it is increased along its length by 25%. So 25% they are increasing in this line segment by producing it to C on the side of B. That is from B they are producing it to C. 25% they are increasing. Okay, so if we for calculating, we are asked to find the coordinate point of C. So for finding that, A and B totally will take it as 100%. In this 25% they are increasing. Okay, so from this the 25% of this they are increasing. Okay, so 25% means 25 by 100, so that is 1 by 4. So from this we will divide this AB in the ratio of, that is 4 parts it is there, in that one part they are increasing to C. Okay, so totally A to B will take it as 100%. So in that 25% of that particular point they are increasing. So totally 4 parts is there, in that 4 part 1 part. So that is, so we will take like this. Like this, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. In this 4 part, from this, we will take this as P. Okay, this PB, they are increasing to B. Why? Because this is in the ratio 3:1. That is, this is only 25%. So, this 25% they are increasing on the other side. So, we will take the ratio of this as 3:1. So, totally 4 parts. In that one part is 25%. Okay, so that 25% only they are increasing on the side of B. Okay, so we got the ratio for this line segment, and then we will find the coordinate point of P. Then we will take this B, the same part they are increasing, means this B will be the center point, midpoint. So we got the point of coordinate point of B, P. We got the coordinate point of B, already it is there. Then we will find it using midpoint formula. This is how we are going to do. Okay, so we will use section formula first. Since the ratio we got it as 3:1. A and B coordinates are there. We will find the coordinate point of P. Okay, so coordinate of P. This is using section formula. That is mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. So m and n are 3:1. So m is 3, x1, y1 we will take it as this one. That is A point is x1, y1, B is x2, y2. So this is 3x2. So 3 into 2 plus 1 into x1 is minus 2 divided by 3 plus 1, comma m is 3, y2 is 1. Plus n is 1, y1 is minus 3 divided by 3 plus 1. Okay, so now we will simplify this. This is 6 minus 2 by 4, comma 3 minus 3 by 4. So when we simplify this, 4 by 4, comma 0 by 4 we will get. So the coordinate points of P are 1, comma 0. So we got the point of coordinate point of P. That is 1, comma 0. 1, comma 0 is the coordinate point of P. Okay, so now midpoint of PC. Midpoint of, so the same thing only we are increasing here. So this obviously the P will, B will be the midpoint. So midpoint of PC is B. Midpoint of PC is B. Okay, so we use midpoint formula. X1, Y1 is coordinate point of P. P point is X1, Y1. C is, we will take it as X2, Y2. We don't know, this only we have to find. So we'll take that point as x2, y2. So p is 1, 1 comma 0. So x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 is 0 plus y2 by 2. For this, b is the midpoint. So what is the b coordinate? 2 comma 1. So when we equate this, we will get the points x2, y2. Okay. So 1 plus x2 by 2 is equal to 2. 0 plus y2 by 2 is equal to 1. So 1 plus x2 is equal to 4. So x2 is equal to 4 minus 1, that is 3. Okay. So here y2 is equal to 2. 0 plus y2 is equal to 2 is equal to 1. By 2 is equal to 1. So when we cross multiply, we will get y2 as 2. So we are asked to find the coordinate points of C. So that coordinate point is coordinates of C. So C is 3 comma 2. So this is the thing we are asked to do. Okay.